Hockey Centre for all the pre-game action before the preliminary final in the men's Vic League One competition between Yarra Valley and Casey Hockey Club. My name is Kin Smith. I'm joined by Izzy Hassel, who is fresh off cheering her KBH Brumbies to a preliminary final victory over Melbourne University. But Izzy, we've got another game on our hands here, and it's going to shape up to be another really tight, physical, tough affair. Yarra Valley versus Casey. The winner will meet Mentone in the grand final, who booked their spot with a shootout victory over Yarra last week. And Casey winning the elimination final 2-1 against Tem. So a massive game. Like Joe earlier, I'm going to declare my allegiance. the
you
boys,
have to.
Yeah, I have to. The boys in yellow and blue are my mob. So I might have a little bit of one eye going on, but I'll do my best.
Yeah, absolutely. We do have a massive game coming up. And Kin, as you said, the Yarra boys will be quite disappointed with last week's loss.
Yeah, so both teams have had great years. And before we jump into that, great mention from Melbourne University. Great game in the prelim. Not quite the result. 2-1 down to the Brumbies, but proud of the effort. And you have to be proud of the effort. Melbourne Uni, it was a sensational game. So, but yeah, look, the games between Mentone and Yarra over the last year have been tight. There's been a 2-1 victory to Yarra down at Mentone, and then a 1-0 victory to Yarra at Yarra Valley. So, you know, it could have gone either way. There were opportunities at both ends. I guess being around the Yarra club, I know they spoke about some things that they weren't happy with how they executed last week. Conversely, Casey did a really great job against Tem, held out Tem early. Tem probably had the opportunity to be 2, maybe 3 goals up in the first 20 minutes, but didn't take their chances. Matthew Light converted a fantastic drag flick into the top left corner to give Casey the lead. Then Tem hit back before Matt Costella sealed it for Casey. So, you know, a really interesting game. There's a lot of top scorers in this game too. I think we've got at least 3 of the top 10 in Matty Light, who plays fullback for Casey, but is a really good drag flicker. And then 2 from Yarra Valley. One, Ash Bannon, who is an incredible player. I think he scored 15 goals this year. And Dante Tate, also with up in the double figures, who's a forward and drag flicker. So it's going to be on for young and old. There's absolutely no two ways about it. And they've had really good years. Casey bouncing back, you know, as we heard from Coach Andrew Shelton earlier. They've changed over a few players in their lineup that we're about to have a look at now.
As you can see, we've got Benjamin Bowman in goals, Blake Edwards, number 2, Matt Costella, number 4, Cameron Ritchie, number 5, Nicholas Wood, number 6, Christopher Wood, number 7, Evan Rundle, number 8, Harrisman Gruel, number 9, Nick Allards, number 11, Stephen McCumber, number 15, Matt Light, as you said, the captain, number 17, Mark Dow, number 18, Liam Allards, number 19, Stephen Stewart, number 21, Peter Jennings, 22, Daniel Godfrey, 69, and Andrew Shelton is the coach, as you said, Kin, and we will shortly get up the Yarra Valley team sheet.
Here we go. So number 1, Tom Cole, the goalkeeper. Number 2, Ash Banner. Number 4, Rob Johnston. Number 5, Brenton Watson. Number 8, Tom Sinai. Number 9, Matt Lovell. Number 11, Owen Pitt. Number 12, Dante Tate. Number 22, Mick Simons. Number 27, Sam Cosgrave. Luke Burnett's not playing today. Number 28, Nick Bridgman. Number 31, Mitch Winnan. Number 32, Elliot Winnan. Number 33, Aiden Filshi. Number 37, Alex Tan. And the reserve goalkeeper, James Cooper. Luke Burnett being replaced by number 45, Jack Hopper today.
Kim, we've got a lot of brothers out there today.
Yeah, we've got a couple. So we've got, I think mainly the from the Yarra Valley side, we've got Mitch Winnan and Elliot Winnan, who is... There's a couple of really good stories in this too, and Liam and Nick Allards as well. So there's a couple of really good stories there. So the Wood brothers as well have played for Casey for a very long time. So this is second versus third, Izzy, and a goal difference of 42 for the Yarra boys, a goal difference of 18 for Casey. Yarra Valley went
it's a
on
big
a
difference.
Yarra Valley went on a streak of I think 10 unbeaten games and had a really good end to the season, and there was a streak of clean sheets there, which they were really impressed with. Defense has certainly been one of the things they've prided themselves on, but they do try to attack the entire game. You know, there's a consistency about how they do that. But Casey always have at this time, I would say, a puncher's chance. They are great combinations, goal scoring. Ash Bannon gets it away. Nick Bridgman straight at the defence. Nick Bridgman following up his own work has Dante Tate in on the inside. Goes to there. Tate still going. Will try and find the corner. Back to Bridgman. Bridgman still going. Watson cleans up. Bridgman. Play on, says umpire Mundy. And a great start from the Yarra boys here. Gustella will try and clear. Fantastic chase from Bridgman. And straight away, like we thought, it is on for young and old.
Casey under the pump straight away. And Yarra really, that's a great start for the game.
Here we go. Matthew Light for Casey to bring the ball out. And this is Cameron Ritchie. Mick Simons with the pressure there. Cam Ritchie, a great player. Very fast, very smart. Works really well in combinations with some of the guys he's played with for a long time. And Matt Costella, Steve McCumber, Godfrey. Working around with Ritchie. Those three have played a lot of hockey together as Mick Simons chases.
Ritchie going back to Light. Yarra just holding back right now. And a great overhead from Light.
And Pitt will clean this up. Good tackle by Allards there. A little bit dangerous. There was a good overhead from Lighty. Gustella was just sinking in behind the defence there.
This Evan Rundle there just losing possession. Looking for Gustella, as you said.
Yeah, Aiden Filshi, really quality and exciting young player.
We'll see his sister in action next week.
Yes, you will. His sister Katrina, who plays in the women's ones. At I think she's only 15 years of age and holds down centre-back in the women's Vic League One competition, which is pretty exciting. So this is Johnston out to Cosgrave. Cosgrave working with Watson as well. You can see Casey also just trying to find their way through Bridgman, back to Lovell, to Watson. And great trap by Phil. She can keep going, still going.
Met by Light. Good defence by Casey.
Filshi, good skills there. That's going to be a free hit. Matty Light's got to watch some of those tackles. This is Watson. Again, Light on the ground. Watson across and straight out over, but McCumber gets the benefit of the doubt there, which is fair enough.
It was almost a cricket shot, wasn't it?
Yeah. Bannon on the ball can go across to Watson.
It's a good tackle there. Found the foot.
Good hit. Free hit there. So Light will go up and over. And 5 yards there. And Casey protest, but it was coming down into the traffic. That's got to be a free hit out. So I also have to give a big shout out to, I know there's some people internationally watching this game. First of all, Phil Newen in the UK from the Latrobe Hockey Club. I believe he sent me a tweet. He's just gotten home from a night out and he's switched on the live stream. So Phil, a big hello to you. And hopefully our good friend Raf McQueenie, who's all in Shanghai at the moment, I think, getting involved there. So Raf, if you're watching too, hello.
Tweet us in if you're watching. Again, above the head, but taking control of. Under a lot of pressure from two Casey strikers then. Yeah, just looking for the foot. Then he called it his knee, but...
That's Bridgman there putting the pressure on, but just couldn't pick the pocket quite clean enough. Umpire Mundy right on the spot. Mundy and Glenn Mundy, a good friend of ours at the live stream, and Benny Hocking in control of this game as Mick Simons continues to pressure.
It's a good idea to touch up the line, but Sammy Cosgrave just read it a little bit quicker than his Casey opponent.
Filshi very composed in that situation. Back to Johnston. Of course, there is one player missing for the Yarra boys at the moment, and that's Josh Hawes, brother of Coach Zach. So Josh is back in the Netherlands at the moment. We've got no idea when he'll be back, actually. Some might find that hard to believe. There we go. Free hit to Yarra Valley.
Kinsey might need him back for next week.
Hopefully he is back.
Let's not speak too soon. Brenton Watson over the ball for Yarra.
Here we go. Owen Pitt taking off. Can put a good, dangerous ball in and no one there. It'll be a 16-yard. Benny Bowman just watching that one roll out over.
Matty Light now. Looked to go the overhead again, but puts it out to Gruhl. good ball infield. Couldn't quite drive it cleanly though, Rundle.
Yeah, well picked off by Tate there. And the ball straight through. Great ball to Simons, who can go at light. And we're still going. Watson can take off. Feed out to Pitt. That's a great tackle by Gostella there. This will come over the line, but he'll win the free hit. That was a great tackle.
Yeah, really well done by Gostella there.
Really riding the line there. If he makes contact with the stick, it's a free hit, but good shave tackle coming in. This is Light again. Light will go up and over. Sam Cosgrave under this one. Good pick up by Cosgrave under pressure from Jennings. And wins the free hit.
Another overhead to Bannon, who traps it well.
Bannon still going, has Tate on the outside, still goes. That's third man and a penalty corner for Yarra Valley Hockey Club. Joe's saying rubbish. I say penalty corner. Not actually sure what umpire Mundy saw there, but he's seen something. Bannon maybe impeded in the 25 as he's run towards the circle. And this is an excellent opportunity for Yarra Valley.
Casey really been under the pump for the first 6 minutes of this game.
Yeah, at the same time though, they've had some really interesting options over the top. We were probably, as Yarra Valley, I guess. Gostella almost got out the back there a couple of times, and he is certainly someone you do not want with the ball in the circle. He is just a really crafty striker and a really skillful player. So Matty Light can throw about 75-yard overhead, so they've really got to be careful. Here we go. So it is Tate and Johnston at the top. It will be Tate. Tate with the drag flick and saved off the line by Godfrey. I think they were going for the deflection.
Rundle now for Casey.
Mick Simon still pressuring Watson and Rundle. Watson, great
Watson
skills.
Well.
Keeps going. And Matty Light puts it into the foot of Tate to earn the free hit.
As you said before, Kin, Matty Light can throw a massive overhead, and that's really going to stretch Yarra's defence. They're going to have to be really aware, as you can see just off camera now. The likes of Allard's is quite high up forward.
Good hassle by Bridgman. They're trying to find the ball from Grewal, but Grewal gets it out of trouble and to Ritchie. Interesting, Ritchie's sitting at sort of like a right back, right half situation as Bannon picks this off. Under pressure from Allard's, keeps still going, wins the free hit. Ritchie really dangerous through the middle, and I'd be honestly wondering how long until
they make the change.
Until they try and roll him through there, just because he's so smart and he has a lot of pace and great skills. Trying to find Sinai there was Pitt, so they'll sort out their defense.
As you can see again with that overhead, it's going to roll out the back this time, but yeah, really going to have to be aware of that down in the back. We can see up
and
to our right.
A big shout out to the Mentone boys who are sitting up on the right-hand side of us, just taking in the game. As this is Stephen Stewart. Stephen Stewart takes off, but been told to bring it back by umpire Mundy.
The Mentone boys quite lucky. They can go back and watch this over and over again to see, take notes about whoever wins this game for next week's grand
final. Well picked out by Winnen. That's the back of the stick from Grewal and a little bit of the afters. And again, the overhead trying to find Bannon. They're going to get a shot of the men.
Matty White again. Ops for Ritchie. Through to Rundle. Grewal puts back. Ritchie puts a ball.
That's
under
a
pressure.
Great tackle from Sinai. Still going. Unfortunately, wins the.
Macumba.
And
good ball through,
across.
But couldn't quite
nothing
get a touch.
Nothing out there. Long corner. There we go. That's the Mentone coaches. We've got Scotty Boucher, Luke Michael, and one of the fullbacks sitting up just taking in the game.
I think he knew he was being filmed and got out of it. Casey now with a long corner.
Godfrey back to Light.
Edwards putting pressure on now. Stays really low, does well there, but Yarra too strong in defence.
And that's cut out by Light, or Sinai was out the back there. And this is Elliot Winnan versus Liam Allard. And a great tackle there. Calls a backstick, but I say nowhere near it. Play on.
Liam Allard's quite angry with that one, though. Hit it a little bit too hard back to the long corner spot.
So Richie. Casey with a good amount of possession here in the last few minutes.
Grew well. Good bit of skill, finds the foot. He's got Stewart to his right, but it's a good tackle. Be a long corner.
So the long corner must have just gone out.
Grewell goes all the way back.
Picked up by Light. Interesting, I'll take a quick moment while they're not going forward, although Grewell might put the ball forward here. This is Stewart, Stephen Stewart.
Stewart does well. Very long limbs to get past Sammy Cosgrave, finds a foot.
Yeah, really physical player, Stephen. Kind of flirts with the line a little bit sometimes, and he's got a couple cards for his efforts, but...
I'm liking the battle already between him and Sammy Cosgrave, because Sam will do the same thing back, I reckon.
Oh, just a very quick moment. Actually, I might leave it later. Yeah, there's a bit of going on in the circle there.
Bit of argy-bargy. Grewell.
All the way back to Richie.
Umpires Monday and Hockina will be keeping an eye on the boys now in the circle. Light. I think it's hit a foot there and it's going to be a corner. I actually don't know how that happened. I don't know which post it hit, but it's hit something and come out onto a Yarra Valley foot. He is dangerous all over the field, Kian. I can see why he's got so many goals.
Yeah, I don't... obviously, Ben Hocking's seen something there. I can't see that on replay, but there's no... seems to be no problem from the Yarra guys, so it must have hit something. So this is a good opportunity for Casey here. Matt Light, I think all of his goals are from penalty strokes. And there it is, into the top left. The same place as last week. Matty Light gives Casey the lead here, 1-0.
Tom Cole, the keeper for Yarra, would be pretty disappointed at that one, but
not a lot you can do about
it's
a top left.
Isn't
that's
it?
that's a good goal.
We've
from
got
Casey.
The replay here. Yep, that's just unstoppable, and a very good goal from White. Did set up the corner as well. So Casey with the lead, 1-0 over Yarra.
What I was going to talk about before was you'll see on your screen there, number 45, Jack Hopper, and he. Don't think he'll mind me mentioning this. This is a great story. So last year, before round one, I guess the morning of round one, we got a message that Jack had actually suffered a brain aneurysm while he was in the gym, and had emergency brain surgery overnight, and that was a little bit touch and go for a little while there. And so Jack sat out last year entirely as he recovered from that. He was out of hospital fairly quickly in a few weeks, but so it's great to see him back, not only on the field but playing some really good hockey. A lot of people don't get that chance, so that was a really good outcome for Jack, and they had some incredible surgeons and specialists available to take care of him. So it's just good to see the number 45 running around.
Absolutely, and a really positive story from Yarra, and we'll be keeping an eye on him today as well, see if he can create some magic.
Hope he does well. Here we go. Casey just enjoying a good five-minute period here. Johnston will sweep up.
Can I think so far the difference is Yarra did have the first 5 minutes of the game and were really all over Casey for a bit but couldn't convert. Casey, conversely, had those 5 minutes. Put a goal on the back
of
the net.
Yep, certainly. And, you know, that's how quickly it can turn. You know, if that doesn't, I'm going to assume it hit a foot. I could be wrong, but there's no complaining. So You know, and that's the difference. Yarra had the corner and couldn't convert as Matt Light goes up over the top once more.
Oh, that's going to be straight down. I think that's Gustella down there. Has collided with Cole.
He's absolutely out. Cole's looking shaken up too.
Had the benefit of the padding, but Cole will still be, as you said, quite shaken up. Lucky they've got a Cooper on the side.
Yeah, no, Cole looks all right. I'm a bit more concerned about Gustella, to be honest.
You can see both Casey and Yarra just getting together now. Going to have a few words to each other. There's not much that they can do now.
Yeah, good to see Gustella sitting up there. So, but I would say he was knocked cold then because he was not moving. So,
all right, we can see him getting up now. Very good signs out there.
So we'll have a bit of a replay here. Good to see Gustella, Matty back on his feet and up here. Cole's just gone for it and.
Yeah, they were both just watching the ball, really, Ken.
Yeah.
There's nothing malicious at all in that. And you can see Gustella now jogging off. That's really good news for Gustella and for Casey. Cole also right in the net. So good outcome from that. But that's what hockey does sometimes. Just
it'll be interesting to know if Gustella's going to play any further part. Because if he has been knocked out,
he needs to sit on the bench, really.
Yeah. Concussions and that kind of stuff are a huge topic in world sport at the moment, and it's just not worth it. And again, I would put my hand on my heart and say that if it was a Yarra guy, I would be saying exactly the same thing. It's something I know a little bit about, not as much as others, but I would be saying that they would need to stay off. Bad luck there for Tom Snyder, just not able to reel in that cross from Bridgman. He would have been in for the shot on Benny Bowen's goal.
Ken, just as you said before, Gustella's going to be a real real loss actually now for Casey.
If he is out, that is a big loss. Yep. Again, we just hope that he's okay. And
yeah, absolutely.
It's interesting, I didn't see any heavy contact, I guess, sometimes like you would expect with the head or anything like that. So, yeah, it must have been when he hit the ground.
Good desperation from the Allards brothers there. Richie for Casey. Grew well.
We go, Gruel to Godfrey.
Light was looking for a little bit more around to his right, I think, there.
This is Mitch Winnan. Mitch Winnan, young guy with great skills, feeds Lovell. Lovell to Watson. Watson out to Bridgman. Bridgman been involved in everything so far. Can come back inside and resets to Filshi. Oh! And I think Stewart's just hurt himself there too. He looks like he's just twinged a knee.
And he knew it straight away. He's just hobbling off right in front of us now. Edwards come, going on for him.
He's come straight off. And if Stewart and Gustella are not at their best, that is a big hurdle for Casey.
Watson just turning that one over. Makumba.
Makumba, great tackle by Johnson. Watson picks up his own good work and feeds Lovell outside. Great tackle, Robbie Johnson.
Watson did really well to make up for that blunder. Lovell.
Winnan driving at the circle. Hassled by Light to Watson. Watson across. Free hit. Just outside and the whistle was late. So no problem with the clearing of the ball there. As I welcome Joe Hassel back into commentary.
Not yet.
And another free hit earned by Watson outside the circle. And there we go. Penalty Corner, no. It says said it's come up off Bridgman's foot first, I think. Joe, you've been sitting out of the action for almost 20 minutes. How do you see this going in the first 20 minutes?
Look, I think Yarra seem to have more possession, but Casey look more dangerous. When they do go forward, they look like they've got more weapons. And the goal they got was a blinder off the corner.
Goal.
Yeah. Haven't necessarily seen a shot from Yarra. Now, there's been a couple of circle entries, but not really a whole lot of shots. I'll tell you what, those two injuries, they both look serious, and we are only halfway through the first half. I think that might have a really telling play in what transpires for the next hour or so.
Well, look, we were talking about it before. I think you would suspect that Matt Costello will play no further part in this game, and that's purely from a conservative point of view, just managing his health.
But just off camera, I actually, with our producer Mozzie, we looked at the replay of that incident a couple of times before we showed it to everyone else, and it was two guys, the goalie, eyes on the ball, yep. And the overhead was coming, and they were both watching the ball. I think he hurt his head when he hit the ground.
Yep.
I think it was a body check, and when his head hit the ground, that's perhaps where the damage was done.
Phil Shee to Watson. Watson can find Sinai. This is good for Yarra Valley. Bad execution from Sinai there, and a good tackle by Godfrey to get that ball out.
Godfrey's tackle was unbelievable. He stayed low and shows a lot of courage. Stayed low when someone was doing the turnaround jumper at you.
Sinai would have expected better from himself there. And Matt Costello walking around the sideline there. He looks like he's going to come back on.
It's surprising. He looked like he was out.
To be honest, it is. It's really surprising.
We'll let that one go. Yeah, Casey are managing it their way.
Yep.
Richie now at the ball with Light at the back. Light's a good player, isn't he?
Bad luck there for Wood. Just the missed trap over the sideline.
We both see a lot of this grade. Men's Vic League 1. Of course, I've watched the Brumbies all year. The couple of times we've played Casey, they seem to be a very physical team, and they really
yep.
they don't mind losing some skin and getting in and sliding in with some tackles. That might cause them a bit of trouble with cards from time to time, because it's pretty deliberate. They have to take the ball. If you don't take the ball and you take the guy's ankles, then it's probably a yellow. I think that hit Watson's foot.
Too Ooh. High, says umpire Mundy. Yep. Had the perfect angle for it.
Yeah, we're a little bit too elevated on that one, aren't we? Guys, for your info, we're probably looking at the same angle you are. We're standing right next to the guys who are doing a brilliant job again on the cameras. And we trust that you're really enjoying the live stream. I enjoyed that first game, Kin. Perhaps a little bit more than you're enjoying this one with Yarra Valley trailing 1-0.
It's a tight game as both teams are trading body shots through the middle here. And Yarra Valley, like you said, they've got to get some conversion for their effort. Sinai would have expected better of himself on that opportunity before.
Edwards. Ooh. Interesting. Alex Tan thought it was Casey's ball. Blake Edwards thought it was Casey's ball. Umpire Mundy thought it was Yarra's ball. And that's the way it goes.
He who hath the whistle hath the power.
There's that.
That's a free hit outside the first one. Elliot Winnan was teeing up then. Matty Light's got to be really careful with going to... He's gone to ground on a lot of tackles. And if that...
Is he teaching the rest of them to do it? He's not the only one that's gone to ground on those tackles. Richie giving Watson a bit of...
I think the thing is, it's interesting. If they're willing to flirt with the line, then you make the umpire make the decision. And I think, you know, they'll wear it either way. Bad luck there for Pitt as the bubbling trap comes up over the sideline.
Now, they're breaking fast here. They've realised... And here comes the through ball, and he's connected. And the ball's going to hit the post there.
Cole had that covered, even if it did come back out.
It's interesting. Now, talk about that, Kin. We were both at a game yesterday. We were at a Women's Vic League Reserve game, folks, where Kin and I have seen something we've never seen before. The ball in that situation hit the post. The goalie turned around and kicked it out, and it hit the corner post and stayed in play. It was the most remarkable thing you've ever seen.
And then she proceeded to kick it straight out.
Oh, that was that was on the shootout. That happened a little bit later in the day.
Yeah. Which, the same keeper in a shootout kicked the ball into the post as well.
Yes, it was.
It was incredible scenes.
It was a post corner flag followed by a poster about 30 minutes later.
So 12 minutes to go in this opening half. That is online almost with your scoreboard there too. As Pitt cuts that ball out, Grewal will have Dante Tate and Bridgman to contend with, relieves the pressure to Richie.
And Richie gets a ball out to Light. Light looks up ahead, see what's in front. He's looking for Allard's on the spot, and it's it. There he goes! Quasella, he's gone down 5 minutes ago. He's picked himself up, and he's got a deflection goal. Brilliant play by Light, who found him through a gaping hole through the middle, and he's got the touch on it. Casey go to a 2-0 victory. 2-0 lead. The victory's not there. Probably shouldn't have got through.
Yeah, there's two mistraps there at the top as the ball goes through. So
seemed to be a set play. Park yourself in front of the goalkeeper and smash hard for him. That was quite a deliberate ploy. So Yarra now had the job in front of him. There's still 11 minutes to go in this first half. Of course, all of the second half. But it might just change. I'm surprised they're playing it so safe now, Kin. I mean, there is a long way to go. But perhaps they need to penetrate a little bit more and give it to their dynamic attackers like Ash Bannon and co. Light. Richie.
See, there's the one that you don't like. It's bobbled up and hit Richie's foot, and umpire Mundy has said play on.
Well, that's the way they're told to do it. And neither of us like the rule. And I think your analogy to the rugby, Ash Bannon, what can he make of this? Cops a big hot body check, but plays on. Probably could have got the first free for it. Wasn't a whole lot of advantage to Ash Bannon after copying that body check. Ball comes through. Well played.
Well done by Phil Shee, who can feed inside to Bridgman.
Now, Phil Shee's only a very young player. Is he 18 yet?
17.
17.
17 years old at this point. So that's probably within five, I'd like to suggest, Glenn, but that's okay.
And he might have. he might still be aware of that. No, he hasn't brought it back.
They blew the whistle early, unfortunately, so and there can be they can't let the play go on once they've blown the whistle. So
now that second goal's gone in, and Casey have hardly hit the circle. They just seem to be more dangerous when they do go forward, and they are going forward again. Allard's.
Johnston tries to find Phil. She turns the ball over.
Is that Johnston who's a fullback?
Yeah, it is, actually.
Every team has one. Every team has one. We say it every week because it happens every week. Every team has a Jono fullback. I see Johnson Figueroa's got the John Storen beard going. Seems to be very trendy
the beard
through
the
inner north suburbs. Allard's now. I call it the Storen. Here's Gruel. He gets into the circle. I think that was a kick and...
Yeah, off the foot of Tate there in the right-hand side. And this, again, is danger time for Yarra Valley.
Gruel is a very skillful player. There's no doubt about that. He just had beautiful control over the ball. Look, it's interesting, Kin, that we just look at the stats. Shane Hackett's been providing stats for us, which is fantastic. Circle entries are 6 to Yarra Valley and only 4 to Casey, and yet of those 4 circle entries, they've scored twice, and now they possibly going to put another one on the board. Comes to Light at the top. It worked the first time, and that was rocketed.
Yeah, that was travelling. He was going for a similar spot. Thankfully for Tom Cole and co, did not find the net.
It's a weapon. They have a real weapon on their corners, and I think Casey will go to that as often as possible as Bannon misses a trap.
Yeah, the bobbling trap.
Yeah, difficult one to trap. But you need to.
Correct. So here we go. Mick Simons pressuring Matty Light. Relieves it to Cameron Ritchie.
Ball bobbles around and Casey still have it.
And so this is Stewart back on the pitch as well. So Stewart just sucks Cosgrave in there. Still going.
This is danger. There's the shot on net and in it
and
goes.
There's the third goal. Steve McCumber puts Casey 3-0 up with 7.5 minutes to go. The clearance found the Casey forward, who absolutely buried that into the bottom left-hand corner.
Here's the replay. The ball just came loose and it was cleared. Yeah, it could have gone anywhere. It's gone straight to the one man that was at the top of the circle. Didn't quite go wide enough. But you're taught not to put it up the middle, and he didn't put it up the middle. He went wide-ish. and McCumber with a clinical finish once he had a little bit of time and space. This is a big turn up, Kin, and Yarra have a big job in front of them with just under 7 minutes to go in the first half. And yet again, I'll probably repeat what we said earlier. It's only the fifth time Casey have actually got into the circle and they've scored three times.
We did say that they definitely had a puncher's chance and that they would convert with opportunities in the circle.
And here's an good contest. Great contest, both players. And brilliantly umpired too. There's two guys going hard at the ball. The Yarra guy got to it first. Just a split second in it. And they've let the boys play. Is that Cosgrave out there? He's a bit dizzy.
Yeah, he's a bit shaken up there.
It was a hard physical contest between the two of them. I didn't think it was that bad though.
Sammy's walking off under his own power, which is good, but he doesn't look great, to be honest.
No. And he's with Neil Watson, a stalwart of the Yarra Valley Hockey Club.
Yep.
And centre-half in the Yarra Valley Premiership in the 80s, Kin. And I remember watching that game.
1982, if my memory
and
serves
And Neil
me
was
correct.
Running a little bit quicker back then than he is today.
He might dispute that. He said he was never blessed with pace, but could deliver a ball. So, Watto, just roaming centre-half there. So Cosgrave has been replaced by Elliot Winnan out at left half.
Actually, it's interesting. Neil did play a simple game. He had a lot of great players around him, but he just kept getting them all involved. He was a really smart player.
Another good story, just again, some home knowledge from as he turns the ball over. Elliot Winnan, who's playing today, missed all last year too with glandular fever. So had some pretty bad complications from glandular fever, but has gotten back into the team as the ball comes across and off the foot of Jennings there.
There's a big overhead, but not very effective.
So, folks, even though the count-up clock there says we have about 2.5 minutes to go, we've got 5 minutes and 19 seconds left.
Well, we've had a couple of injuries that, particularly that one to Guastella, we thought was perhaps a bit more serious than it's turned out to be.
Unless he was seeing three balls and just tried to deflect the middle one.
Okay. Well, he chose the right one, didn't he? Casey again. Turned out by Jono. Jono, the fullback.
Robbie sets Mick Simons a chase, but Mick won't get on the end of that one.
Kin, I think Yarra seem to be missing the connection between the mids and the attacks. They're getting yep. into the midfield, but they're not making the connection. Now, that can be two things. It can either be Yarra need to lift their game in their area, or perhaps, and probably what I think it is, just the setup and the positioning of the Casey fullbacks, such as Light, who just has thrown the overhead there. It's probably more that. Filshi, well played to shut down that attack. It's just the connection, I think, that from the centre line into the circle is not clean. Wood.
This is Wood against Lovell.
Bannon.
Bannon earns that free hit there.
It goes the overhead and it's pulled down. Not sure if he was five. The umpire says he was. And here it comes again, this time. The overhead is more successful. Bannon, he's got some tricks. Throws the ball in, the ball bounces around, but it's a long corner.
He was looking for the lead of Tate there, which is acknowledged by the thumbs up.
Ash
Bannon is probably, in the Vic League One competition, you would struggle to find a person who sees a better through ball or weights a ball better than Bannon. Bannon crashes it in.
Oh, he saw a good one there too. There was Yarra blokes lining up. And it's missed. It hasn't taken anyone's stick, which I don't know how it didn't take any deflections there. Look, it's interesting, Kin. Is Ash? He's a good one-on-one player too. He can eliminate a bloke if he's got one-on-one.
Yeah.
I think maybe because of the structure, or maybe because of the structure of Casey's defence, he maybe should back himself and take him on one-on-one and use his skill there a little bit, as Watson just plays it safe and gets back to Johnson.
This is Pitt trying to find the long ball for Sinite.
Interesting. Third man when he was coming from behind. Back to Bannon. Play we're just talking about. There's that individual skill. My word, look at that. Ash Bannon. Done another one. Done another one. Play on. No corner there. Great defence in the end.
Yeah, back of the stick there from Matty Light. And this is could be an opportunity for Yarra to get back into the game. They certainly need to convert this. A penalty corner. Skills from Bannon were unbelievable. He couldn't find the foot. He was looking for it. He looked for the shot. Wasn't there. Tried to put it onto the foot. But then the diving clearance from Light. Umpire Mundy just said gets the back stick.
Watch this.
Yep, you can see as the ball, you can always tell when the ball dips down to the turf and bounces up, that means you've hit it down, which means you can only have hit it with the round side. So
I reckon the other signal, let's just focus on the corner.
So this is across to Johnston. That's another penalty corner.
I reckon the key to it is if the hook of the stick is pointed up. If the hook of the stick is slightly elevated, then it must be the back of the stick.
Yep.
If it's flat, and let's see what happens here. Light, I might have been there. Oh, actually, I reckon the stick was pointed up there anyway. Great decision, Glenn Mundy. How hard is it?
Very.
We've just seen two replays.
And we can't tell. Here we go.
Okay. In motion, Yarra.
Dante Tate, that's another penalty corner.
Okay, now, something that's been discussed in various Vic League hockey. Did you see that? Something fantastic, very funny just happened in front of us. Number 9 from Yarra, Matt Lavell, came to talk to Zach Hawes just to find out what the combination was. And two of the Casey blokes came to have a listen. I've never seen that.
That's another penalty corner. Yep. So we'll see if they do it again. They're padding the stats, the Yarra boys, but this there's only 30 seconds left to go in the game. We'll see if they do it again or if they're they've waved Lovell off.
That was extraordinary what we just saw down on the bench.
Yeah, so they're going to wait till the end of the game here. 10 seconds to go.
So this is important. Can Yarra convert this corner and go into the second half with some momentum? They certainly need to. 3 goals is a big deficit at halftime. Here go, Yarra.
It is to Tate. Drag flick. Winnen and another penalty corner.
Well played, Winnen. That was
just
really good.
Just really good strength. Great strength down. Great strength down low, Elliot.
Now Brenton Watson has dashed off the field and had a chat to the coach Zach Hawes. There was no Casey players running to put their nose into that one. That was very funny. I've never seen that, Kin.
Yeah.
I think I'm going to see it more and more. I think it might be a tactic that people take on. More than anything, just to really get up the nose of the opposition coach. Talk us through this one, and you're allowed to barrack, Kin. Go for it.
So here we go, the injection. It is going to be across to Johnston, and another penalty, and he's pulled it out of the net. He's blown the whistle as Bridgman has finished.
I think that was correct. When the ball is hip height, you can't have sticks swinging around.
Yep, I agree.
And he blew it early, and I think the ball was put in just after.
I'll agree with you. I'll put my logic hat on and say, yep, that's correct.
Okay. Now swap hats again.
Yep.
And call the Yarra goal for us.
Here we go. It'll go out to the top. It is Johnson through to Pitt and up and over the net from Tom Sinai. The deflection was there, but it's gone too high. And that is the end of the first half between Yarra and Casey. Casey lead 3-0 to the good. Yarra with a lot of work to do.
Folks, we'll be back after this.
Volvo Cars Bilia has arrived in South Yarra. Our new showroom showcases the latest models from Volvo Sweden. And with over 20 years of experience, look to Bilia for your next Volvo journey. Volvo Cars Bilia. That's where Volvos come from.
Hello, I'm Andrea Snow from the Doncaster Hockey Club. We're a leading community hockey club in Victoria with over 500 members. Doncaster Hockey Club provides participation opportunities for people of all ages and abilities, for programs with people with disability, women and girls, masters, right the way through to the development of Victoria and Australia's future stars. We currently have two Doncaster players representing Australia in the Kookaburras. Our partnership with our sponsors, Bendigo Bank, is very important to us. It helps underwrite the programs that we deliver. It's simple. By switching your banking to Bendigo Bank, you'll assist us to continue to build this strong community club.
When there's love in your eye, it's so hard to deny. That's Tipaldi. When the taste is just right, it's the flavour of life. That's Tipaldi.
For the best salami and deli meat since 1934, that's flavour, that's Tipaldi.
When the taste is just right, it's the flavour of life. That's Tipaldi.
Hi, do you know that most first aid emergencies happen in and around the home? Did you know that less than 5% of Australians are trained in first aid? Most families struggle for time and find it difficult to attend a full day's first aid training course. Well, now there's a better way. First Aid Fast. First Aid Fast is a fresh, new approach to learning first aid. Our training is fun and provides an ideal environment for individuals and families to learn life-saving skills. In just 3 hours, we'll teach you key first aid principles. No pre-work and no tests. Our course covers topics met by national standards and delivered by qualified trainers. Each person will receive a course kit and a certificate of completion. Better still, Australian First Aid can come to you, to your home, club or workplace. For dates, prices or to book today, call 1300 975 889 or go to our website, australianfirstaid.com.au. First Aid Fast, solutions to save lives.
Life's full of little uncertainties, like you can never be sure that style runs in the family. And is your husband really mowing the lawn? So how can you be certain your new home will be built exactly as you imagined? GJ Plus gives you more certainty through every stage of your build, and your local GJ team will be with you every step of the way. In fact, we're probably already closer than you think. GJ Gardner Homes, where certainty makes all the difference.
Quest Apartments Bundoora is the home away from home where you can quickly settle in and go about your day. The AAA rated 4.5 star property provides everything a business traveller needs to ensure their stay is a productive and comfortable one. With friendly staff and modern facilities, you can be sure that Quest Apartments Bundoora is the right choice for your next business trip.
Welcome back, hockey fans, to the State Netball and Hockey Centre. We are halfway in the Men's Vic League game between Yarra Valley and Casey. Extraordinary result. I'm with Izzy. My name's Joe. I'm with Izzy. Casey are leading 3-0. It's extraordinary.
We would not have expected it, Joe. At the start of this game, I thought Yarra were probably going to have the better of the game. And I guess you could just about say they have had much more of the ball. But Casey can finish. Casey, you've gone into their attack maybe six or seven times and scored three of those.
Well, let's have a look at the stats before we get underway again, folks. Shots on goal, four each, and the score is 3-0 to Casey. Circle entries, 7 to Yarra, 5 to Casey. So on their 5 entries, they've scored 3 times. And penalty corners, 7 to Yarra Valley and 2 to Casey. And Casey scored on one of them. The other one went flying over the top, which was, I think the goalie was beaten, but unfortunately didn't keep it underneath that the crossbar. So just the weaponry they've got up forward is means they're leading 3-0 and they're well on the way to a grand final spot against Mentone next week.
Absolutely. I would not count Yarra out, though, yet. Zach Hawes would have had a big chat to them at halftime, and Yarra will come out firing. We know that they are a quality hockey side across the field, and I have no doubt that they will make this second half one to watch. Sammy Cosgrave over the ball.
It's been a couple of little injuries. We had a knee, a couple of head knocks, which are all purely accidental. The game's been played. It's a hard physical game, is. And I was talking to Kin a bit earlier when our Brumbies boys played against both of these teams. Both games were very physical. I would say, especially the Casey boys play a very physical brand of hockey. It's quite fair, but it's very physical.
Absolutely, they are very physical, but as you said, mostly fair. And as long as I can keep themselves on the field and not get any cards, it's completely within the rules of the game, as Johnston puts it out to Cosgrave for Yarra in through to Watson. Watson.
That was an example of that physicality, the pressure that number 22, Peter Jennings, put on Cosgrave. He earned that possession, didn't he?
He really did. They really put pressure on the back four or five every time. And Ash Bannon now, I reckon he might have been first to the ball there.
I'd say Ash Bannon was clearly first to the ball on that occasion. Except that's another rule I have a bit of trouble with. Now, look, Cosgrave has clashed with Allard's way off the ball, and Allard's is tumbling around. Wasn't far away from Mundy. I think it was props accidental. Oh, look, Cosgrave has... There's a lot going on behind the ball, folks, between Allard's and Cosgrave. And what Cosgrave is trying to do is take Allard's line as he's making a lead. He's just stepping right in and giving him hip and shoulder. Mundy's got to do something about it. It's happening right in front of him. Gruel.
I think the fact that it is happening right in front of him shows that what Cosgrave is doing is within the rules. Otherwise, Mundy would be picking up on it.
I'll tell you what I saw is Cosgrave turned and looked at Allard's and stepped right into his line and dropped his shoulder. That's actually what we saw right in front of us. I'm not sure if we picked that up on the live stream. But it was in front of Mundy. And I'm sure if it gets out of hand, he'll do something with it.
He certainly will. Yarra now looking forward.
Gruel gets an important touch on it.
Filshi. This is Aiden Filshi.
It's interesting.
Goes all the way back to Johnston. To Watson now. He's just moved around to the left on his back stick now. It's a good tackle.
That was McCumber, the goal scorer. He scored a cracking goal. He had time and space to pick his spot, and he certainly did that.
And such reflexes to trap that one as well before getting off for an absolute ripper shot. Here's Ash Bannon on the reverse.
Ball's bouncing around again. Godfrey clears the ball away from the top of the circle, throws it out with his reverse, and it goes on the other side of the field.
Owen Pitt, the captain, searching ball through just a little bit too high. Yarra looking a bit more desperate now. They know they've only got 35 minutes to get at least three goals.
And here's an opportunity again. This is Guastella. That was an overhead that was quite penetrating. Is I just want to take it back to that ball from Pitt. I think that's where they're breaking down. It's happened way too much from about in the middle of the field. They're just not connecting with their strikers, and possession's been turned over, mostly about the attacking 25. And there's another example. It was probably a little bit further back, but it's the same thing I'm talking about, is that they're not making that connection with that pass, which I think Zach Hawes would be demanding that they do.
He definitely would. I think, as you said, they've had very clean possession around the back line. Despite the pressure that Casey are putting on them, they've been able to really handle that well, but as you said, it's just when they get into attack that they can't connect those passes. And it's not the first time we've spoken about a team doing that on the live stream this year. I know we had almost the same issue with Campbell, who were really strong through defence, but couldn't connect with the
Campbell's
with
women.
The strike. Yeah, yeah, Campbell's women. Sorry.
Yep. I don't think Campbell's men have much trouble with that.
Not at all. The men don't. Campbell's women are a little bit similar to Yarra in this way that they've got a very strong defence and midfield, but can't make that last pass.
This is Wood. This is Christopher Wood. Beautiful pass. That's the pass we're talking about that Casey are connecting with. And there it goes. Bannon, that's a lovely bit of skill.
Just holding on to the ball, but well tackled. This is Lovell.
Oh, get your hand off the ball, mate. Don't ever pick up. Youngsters at home, don't ever pick up the ball because someone might come along and hit it. And that'd be bad.
Good trap by Bannon. He's been caught against his foot. From where I'm looking, it didn't hit his foot.
I think his stick was right in front of his left foot. And we have a much better angle than the umpire on that one. Light. He's gone over a few times, and that's another one. And every time it's lobbed into space, I bang on about the overheads and how effective they are. That one, again, ends up with the Yarra position. However, the difference is with Light is that he's putting the ball into space and not to a contest. And that's where I think Light's overheads are much more effective than a lot of others we've seen through the year.
Definitely. I'd certainly love to have Light in my team throwing it over. He can just about throw 75 metres, which is pretty incredible.
I like him putting for me because he can put it any distance he likes. Here we go. And here he is. This is the player we're talking about. His judgment. Look at that pass. That was a beautiful pass through to Edwards, who probably should have done a little bit better. And he acknowledges Light and says, thanks, mate. That was a great ball, which means, yes, I know I should have done a bit better on that one. It was interesting, again, Matt Light, his positioning there to pick that ball off. He just seems to be a bit of a floating player. And there's Pitt has turned it over again. And I don't mean to pick on him, but we've seen it 3 or 4 times. And the ball's not ending up with the Yarra stick after he's got it. Light. That ball's about hip height. Allard's wins a contest. Stick around the back. Big tackle from Cosgrove. Those two at it again.
A little bit of a shoulder on the way through. Again, Monday. Look thinks it's all fair.
Look at what's happening in the circle. There's a crowd of players and Allard's has been the one that's released and he's got out. A little jinking run. He's got the ball to a teammate in there. That's hit a Yarra foot. And another Yarra player has hit the ball away. A little bit lucky it's not a corner. And now Glenn Munday is saying, you two, I'm sick of it. Glenn's probably a little bit late. It's been going on for 10 minutes and it's still going on. Gruel with the ball. It'll make for an interesting half of hockey, I tell you. Richie, all the way back. Gruel's just changed the point of attack and they've changed it again. Light, see what he picks out. He looks forward. Allard's under pressure. Little bunt. Get to Gruel. What a drag. That is hockey skill at its highest. And that was a great tackle by Pitt, but unfortunately the umpire saw an infringement. I thought it looked like a pretty clean tackle by Pitt. It was a pretty good effort. Lovely bit of skill by Gruel. He's got some tricks.
He certainly does, Gruel.
Matt Light sneaking around again, and that's where it goes. Here it comes. The ball smash into the circle. It hits someone's foot. And the Casey guys were saying it was a Yarra foot, but as soon as Munday said, no, it wasn't, it was a Casey foot, they've turned around and trotted back. Here's the overhead from Pitt.
Another good trap there from White, and that's really good discipline from the Casey boys, sorry, to accept the decision and turn around and get back straight away. Casey, now I've had a lot of the ball, but haven't had any controlled circle entries this half until now. Perhaps Rundle just goes out the
now
back.
Now that's
line.
Our first circle entry, controlled circle entry for the half. The game's been going for pretty much 8.5 minutes, and it just so you, and I feel that Yarra just hanging on at the moment is. Casey have really put them under sustained pressure. Here they come again. Edwards, looked for Allard's. Cosgrave gives him a pat on the back and says, bad luck, mate. It's probably a trap you should have made. And after these two going hammer and tong at each other, it's quite a good moment.
I'm really enjoying this battle between the two of them. Liam on the right wing and Cosgrave on the left half. Filshi now just pops it through to Watson to take the free hit. Watson's got a few options around him. Pops it out to the right. It's a good tackle there. Elliot winning for Yarra. Wynn puts it back again to Watson, who's just moved out to sort of a back position rather than the central that he usually plays. Cosgrave. It's a great ball through to Bannon.
Just his first touch was a bit heavy, wasn't it? It was a great ball from Cosgrave. He found Bannon in the circle. That was a controlled circle entry. However, the first touch from Bannon was a little heavy. Here's a chance.
I think it was a Casey stick.
Dante put his hand up and wanted it. Here's another chance, though. And Casey come away. Stephen Stewart. He's arced a couple of different directions. And now he's connected with his left wing. And this is Nicholas Wood. The ball's rolled into the circle again, but it's come off a Yarra foot on the way through. And now here's Gruel. Top of the circle. Oh, McCumber was sneaking around the back, and if he had got a touch on that, he would have had another shot at goal.
And it would have been from just about the same position as well as his goal in the first half. So Sammy Cosgrave deep in defence now.
Casey had a beautiful play. But again, this is where they're getting turned over. All this half, they've just got turned over there again and again. Stewart gets through the first tackle. Still got the ball, Stewart, great play. He's gone all the way through. But the free hit's been blown from just outside. Casey are looking really dangerous at the moment. Richie now from the right-hand side. Smashes it in. They're looking for another deflection. It's come through. Winnan down there. That was a really strong play by young Winnan.
Casey knocking around the back.
Now, what are they going to do? Smack it in for another deflection? No.
Hopper. Little one out to Bannon, who couldn't control it. So it's Wood now for Casey, looking strength from Watson, but it's gone through a foot there. And Casey... again, they've got that lethal weapon in Light up forward on the drag flick. So
now, Izzy, we are 12 minutes into the second half, and it really has been all Casey. 13 minutes, our count-up clock shows us. And it has been all Casey, and they probably deserve to get some reward for the dominance that they've had in the play. Now, if they do, it's a mountain to climb for Yarra to get back into the game.
Absolutely, Joe.
They have to keep it out. This is a must keep out for Yarra.
Light on the top. To McCumber. McCumber. Slap through and good defence. It's good defence. Lovell's cleared that one out. It's just gone out the back line, so it'll be a long corner for Casey.
And again, Gruel over the ball. As comes out to Richie. Richie connects with McCumber up forward as Kin steps back into the chair. Kin, your Yarra boys are finding it a bit difficult to get over the half line in this half. Casey, you've got a fantastic press on.
Yeah, they're marking hard, Casey, and they've put a fair bit of physicality on the boys as well, which is working for them at the moment as they miscue a pass. 20 minutes to go, 3 goals needed. It's definitely going to be a really tense next 10 minutes.
Light, oh, here's a chance. No, Light just, it was a good steal. Didn't quite come out though. Light had to trap a bouncing ball and Sinai just about picked his pocket.
So Watson with the ball at fullback. Doesn't have a massive amount of options. Goes back to Filshi. Filshi working with Watson again.
Filshi goes the aerial. Nice ball into space. And Wood. Kin, I mentioned to you the first time we're on air together that the Casey boys play a very physical, strong brand of hockey.
Yep. Flirt with the line a little bit.
Yeah, they do, but they seem to do it in a competitive but not aggressive way. And I think some other teams get sucked into it a little bit. A couple of the Yarra boys, I think, are actually getting a crossing line once or twice here because they're not quite handling. But Casey seems to be doing it in a more, probably a, like an English professional soccer player type of way. You know, this is the way we play sort of thing.
Look, they've been in, I mean, they were in Vic League One for 2 years before, I think.
Hang on, let's tune on because, here we go. They're getting into the circle again. Can they win another corner? That's a lovely bit of play, but well defended as well. Gruel now, again for Casey. It's just kicked a foot outside, but the umpires let it play, and they have let it play. Good defence again from Yarra. That's perhaps it, the Premier League experience.
No, they played that way in the 2 years they were in Vic League One before they went up to Premier League. And they play
great
in
tackle.
A way that made...
Alex Tan, great tackle.
Great tackle, Tanny. They played in a way that made umpires make decisions.
Yep.
And that is absolutely not a slight at them. They played hard hockey. You know, probably a lot of Vic League One teams weren't used to that. You even saw before in the defensive circle for Yarra, they were bodying up to the Yarra defenders and almost boxing them in before umpire Mundy had a chat to them. That's why you got umpires.
I'd say it was going the other way in that the Yarra guys were actually trying to concentrate on the body rather than the ball, whereas Okay, I'll stop trying to lead you into it, Ken. No, I suppose what I'm saying, and in fact, I'll take it away from Yarra. When Casey played the Brumbies, which is a game I saw, it was similar. And they played very close to the line, a physical brand, but didn't cross the line, and then the Brumbies did. This is the way we play, rather than actually just do it as a matter of course. Now, that said, what we can't actually dispute is their skill with the ball, and their finishing has just been class hockey.
Well, the difference here has been the clinical nature of their finishing. That's a good tackle.
And not just that, the passing all over the field. The passing, that sort of pass there, I think Casey are connecting with that one better than Yarra are, and that didn't quite connect. But that's the ones we're talking about. They're outplaying them. Casey are outplaying Yarra in most aspects of the game at the moment. And they've certainly had, as we stand and watch from the bird's nest here, we're looking to the right most of the time. Filshi, he's actually played pretty well. Just a young player, he's done quite well, Filshi. It's interesting now they're falling away a little bit. It's not quite a full fall away, but it's a fall away to the 25, and they're saying, Yarra, you can have the ball back there. What are you going to do with it? And at the moment, the answer's not much. They can't get through. Just look at the numbers that Casey have got stacked up in the midfield. Filshi, smart play, but looking for the overhead, and at least they've penetrated. The game compressed there a little bit, Kin. It's interesting. Yarra have now got... it was kicked from the midfield by the Casey player, but they've...
Yeah, I would suggest they might have liked to have that...
in the middle of the field,
in the middle of the field, yeah.
Rather than in a tucked away corner.
Not a massive amount of options there when you're coming in from that corner, and the attempt at cross just going straight out.
It wasn't. This has to be taken down by Cosgrave, and is very well done. Very well done. McCumber, talk about that class and control of the ball. He has not put a foot wrong, McCumber. Wood, Richie. Richie changes direction a couple of times and connects with Wood again. Now the ball comes to Edwards. Edwards got into the circle. There's a stick over there. Clean. Not bad. Nothing wrong with that, says Mundy. And there wasn't either. Well umpired again. In fact, I think the umpiring again has been actually pretty good with a difficult game to umpire because of the physicality that's been going on. Kin, just when you were sitting out before, we noticed in the circle that Allards and Cosgrove are going absolutely going at each other. That's probably what started the conversation I had with Izzy. And here it is again. Gruel. Light. Oh, it's got through. Only just got through, but Wood attacks the top of the circle. And well played, Johnson. Came in, he's stick in the right position. It rolled onto his foot, but he's broken down the attack. That's good defence.
Yeah, made sure he was outside the circle there too.
Interesting. Wood has a dummy step. McCumber, he'll pick something out. That's good. Lovely little change of direction. Got beautiful balance on the ball, hasn't he? And of course, commentator's curse. I'm sure that was Yarra's.
I think that's hit McCumber's foot twice there.
It has, and he's still got it. They've let it go. That's certainly did hit McCumber's foot twice. Wood smacks it in. Ball's bouncing high. It's got to be blown up, and it is. Wood again will take it on the right-hand side. Oh, no, it's where it's dropped. McCumber. Ball's flung in. Johnson gets an important stick on it. Alex Tan comes out with the ball for Yarra. Looks up. He hasn't got much ahead. And Edwards picks his pocket, but not legally. Johnson with the overhead. Oh, this might work for Yarra.
Mitchell Winnan inside. Tomahawk, and he's missed. He's put it to the left. Usually Mitchell Winnan, absolute money from there. The bottom right is his spot, but just unable to get the connection on that.
They needed that one. That would have been really against the run of play too, and would have changed the complexion of the game.
It was a great touch on by Mick Simons too. You would back Mitch to put that in 9 times out of 10. That's a Yarra ball.
Casey is saying we'll give you another chance. Watson.
Watson up.
Oh, he's blown it.
Yeah, and he's blown it. So you can't, with only 13 minutes left to go, it's a critical moment. And
I say this, I'm glad he thought about it. He thought, and what happened there, folks? The free was blown, and then the free was blown. It was definitely Yarra's free, and the Casey player, I think it was number 69, Godfrey, he hit the ball away. It wasn't quite with the whistle. It was just a little bit too long after the whistle, and the umpire had to think about it and said, yeah, I think you're wasting time. I'll give that as a penalty corner. I'm glad he thought about it and thought, yep, that was too long a delay, and that is a short corner. So can this game change? It needs to change for Yarra right now, and this must be converted. They've held them out up the other end for the bulk of this half, and they're in motion.
Here we go. It is Cosgrave to Tate drag flick in front. Oh. And Simons has gone up over the top of the net. And so it remains a clean sheet for Casey. The save from Bowman. And then Mick Simons unable to knock that into the net. Two great chances for Yarra in the last 2 minutes.
It was a good
unable to be able to put away.
It was a good save. A good save that goalies at this level are expected to make.
Yep.
And the rebound, I don't know how he got it over from how close he was. I don't know how quite that got over, but I suppose the ball was bouncing around. It was a little bit too far in front of him. Edwards gets the ball to Allards. Allards looks up. He's got two to beat. He's beaten the two. He's rolled it back, but there's nothing there. Probably should have pulled the trigger there, Allards, and had a ping. Might not have had the time and space because Johnson shut it down for him. McCumber now. McCumber for Casey. Looking for a foot, but there was nothing there. And Yarra will come out.
Sinai. Still going.
Well
Sinai
tackled.
Still going. Back to Hopper. Hopper has his pocket picked by Allards. Still another good tackle by Hopper. Play on call. Johnson will pick up the ball once again. Great pick up by Bridgman and Sinai there against McCumber. Still going. This is Stephen Stewart.
That'll work. Allards.
And Allards has almost hooked his foot there.
It is, but I'll tell you what happened just before. Allards was about to play the ball and all of a sudden was lurching forward. And I think he might have got a nudge in there. That's what he was complaining to the umpire at the back.
Or you can say if he took the ball cleanly and then poked it through.
From underneath him, yeah.
From underneath him. If that's what happened, then that's fair.
Yep. And look, Mundy was on the spot. And he's one of the league's best umpires, so he was on the spot. And he's certainly, the questions have been asked because Both teams have made it very hard for the umpires in this game, I think. It's been such a physical game. And a lot of appealing at the umpires as well. Here they go again. Johnson, he's done a very good job for Yarra at the back. As they back away, it's interesting. Casey is starting to back away. That hasn't quite worked. Are an important couple of chances, Kin. Yarra needed to take at least one of them.
Absolutely, preferably both. But
that would have made it a good game.
That's right, but it wasn't to be, and that's been the difference. The difference is...
The finishing, yeah.
Has been the finishing.
It's interesting, though, for, I would say, the bulk of this half has been in Casey's attacking quarter. And the Yarra defence have actually really held strong in this half. They've done a great job. And the shots have been messy. If shots at all. Here's a through ball. Pitt has got a chance now. Pitt with the ball from Yarra. Now here's the pass that hasn't quite been working for them. That does work. Beautiful ball. Looking for Watson. Just... His first touch wasn't quite good enough because he was under a lot of pressure. Stewart throws it past Cosgrove. And there's that physicality from both players. Wood. This is the other Wood. So it was Christopher Wood, number 7, Nick Wood, number 6. Nick Wood, back to Christopher Wood. He's got a little bit of space, and now he's shut down. And the ball goes
Mundy,
out.
Mundy deemed that Wood threw the ball too far in front of him there.
Another good call.
It's not an easy one to make that, because the player obviously still thinks always they can get it, but, you know.
He could never catch that.
Great pick up by Simons.
Usain Bolt wouldn't have caught that.
Has Richie to deal with. Simons, eyes up, still going. That's a good tackle from Godfrey. Gives it straight back to Filshi. Filshi to Cosgrave. And that's a great ball from Cosgrave, and they needed to talk about that. Simons and Sinai could have coordinated, and Simons had left it. Sinai might have been in on the circle, but Simons now applying the pressure. Matty Light goes up over the top.
Did he just whack his shin pad and he's not even wearing shin pads?
I totally missed that.
What? Well,
so there's 8 minutes to go. Yarra need to respond quickly.
Watson versus McCumber. Watson moves at the 5 metres, gets the ball into the circle, well trapped and cleaned up at the back by the goalkeeper, Bowman. Now, Ken, we've got just under 8 minutes to go, and I've been talking a little bit about the structure. Bannon, beautiful receive under pressure from Edwards. But he's, again, picked up, well played, and thrown away. That could just about be
that
a little bit
more. That should just about
well.
Be a card. Yeah, there. No, they're not going to. But
I'd agree with that. Watson,
now. Yeah, so they need an opportunity here, and a ball in. Tate. And a penalty corner. Now, they've got to take this quickly. They've got to get up and they've got to get this off quickly if they're going to have any chance of getting back into this game. This needs to be converted before the 6.5 minute mark, and then they need to get back into the game.
Now, Ken, a couple of things happened just there. The receive from Bannon in the middle under pressure, but he did receive it, and he was 1-on-3 when he received it, but he was good enough to do something with it. And then the receive and the shot of Dante Tate was just superb. Well defended by Gruhl, even though he's given away a corner, but otherwise the shot's on the net and he got a good piece of it.
Here we go, so Cosgrove on the injection. They've got to get this off quickly, and it is to Pitt, and he's missed over to the left-hand side. I think they were looking for the
Watson
deflection.
Watson was coming in with the back stick deflection on the way through.
Yep. And that makes it very difficult. 6.5 minutes to go.
So we've had a scoreless second half, ladies and gents, but not through want of attack from both teams. There's been chances at both ends. And probably Yarra have had the better of the chances in the second half. They've had three clear chances. And unfortunately, they're still on zero and a three-goal deficit to catch up in this men's preliminary final. And the prize on prelim final day is a spot in the grand final. You go to the big dance. At the moment, Casey are looking very strong, and that will be against Mentone next week. But we've seen funnier things happen. Remember that Vic League 1 grand final a couple of years ago?
Yep, Casey were on the receiving end of that one too, so...
Yeah, they're on the receipt.
So you can always hope. But no, look, it's a massive task. Bannon receives good tackle.
Now, because Casey were on the receiving end of that, it might be less of a problem for them. They're probably well aware of it. One on three. This is Wood, Christopher Wood. He gets to the back line.
Versus
probably
going
to look for a corner. But he gets it, connects with the spot. The ball was rolling right across the spot. He had two teammates running into a dangerous position. And that was danger big time for Yarra's season. Cosgrave. Back to Johnson. And Casey are working very hard off the ball. There's a foot, and that was in play. Watson, great umpiring to let it go because Watson's got possession. He's got Bannon on now by himself. Watson probably could have dished it a little bit earlier, but well played Richie to clean it up at the back. Throwing the ball away, and it's another ball. Now, this is a problem because the ball has gone down the black tube and time's ticking away. The jobs a goalkeeper has to do. Watson.
And just splits the difference between Watson and Sinai. So this will tick down to probably 4 minutes to go, and Casey will be in no hurry to take this.
Matty Light has been excellent in this game. Scored the first goal of the game, which set the scene for a very good patch. Cosgrave, he's had an excellent game as well. Bannon. He finds himself pretty much alone. There wasn't really easy options next to him, so he had to beat one or two players, and he won the free hit. But at this stage, you don't want free hits, you want shots at goal. And as we tick down to 3.5 minutes to go, Matty Light will take it and again slow the play down again. He'll throw it as far as he can. Allards is running on the end of it, but it's going to go just out the sideline, which is probably just about perfect from Matty Light. 70 metre overhead that rolls out the sideline when you've got a few goal lead in a final. Smart play from the experienced Light. Oh, it's just about got through again. Wood missed a trap. And Matty Light trots back after it. Can we do see a difference in Vic League to Premier League? Because ball kids don't let this happen in Premier League, and we'll really see as the next two games get underway in the Women's and Men's Premier League. It will be non-stop action. Richie. Through to Rundle. Rundle to Gruel. Gruel's been really clever this whole game. Back to Richie. They're trying to hang on to the ball now. Dante Tate does a nice little tackle. He's keeping Richie under. Richie's just going to hang on to the ball. He's going to take it deep to the corner. Give it to Gruel. That is a fast drag. And Gruel, and here it is. But they've won it back again. And it's a free hit to Yarra.
So 2.5 minutes to go. You would think it is out of reach for the boys from Yarra. They really needed some of those opportunities to be converted earlier in this second half. The opportunity with Winnen that you would back him, if you know him, to finish that. And then, unfortunately, from Mick Simons, and then the corners not being able to be finished has really put them on the back foot here.
And we contrast that with the first half. Watson still. But Gruel takes it away. And Ken, I think that's probably the ball game.
Yeah,
probably not going to get 3 goals in under 2 minutes.
I wouldn't have thought so.
And so Casey will progress to next week's grand final against Yarra Valley. Cosgrave. They want to get one more before this game's over. And this is a chance. That was on target. And there is a... I think that will be... And Matty Light tries to say, yeah, it was my hand.
Yeah,
Glenn Munday up the other end says, nah, good cooperation and good chat through the earpiece from the umpires. So it was definitely a foot.
They've got to get this one off quickly.
Yeah, and then you'll have to do something fairly remarkable after that. It's interesting...
The umpires haven't called time here. They're within their rights to call time if they want, if they think this is taking a bit long. But
well, they're just taking the same time they take any other time during the game.
Yeah, we're in the last minute now, so this may be the last play of the game. And there's the Yarra bench, a little bit despondent there. Here we go, back to live action now with the penalty corner. And there's one of the goals back. They needed that a little while ago. There's 40 seconds left.
And you notice Casey are not rushing to take this push back very fast at all.
It's interesting. Sometimes the...
what was that? Back of the stick. Liam Mallards has done something very interesting.
Unfortunately, with only 20 seconds to go, I don't think there's going to be a miraculous comeback here. We're in the last 10 seconds, and it'll finish 3-1 to Casey. As we count down, Matty Light will send this up and over the top.
And there it is. That is the last seconds of the game, and so Casey have won the the Men's Vic League preliminary final. That's the word I was trying to say, preliminary final. They've won it 3-1, and the difference in the game was the finishing. It was clinical finishing, particularly in that first half, and so Casey will go on to the grand final against Mentone. The Mentone boys have been watching carefully, interested in what they're seeing and interested in how their defence is going to cope with the finishing power of the Casey boys. Ladies and gents, we're going to be back here after this.